Good morning students. In the previous class we are explaining about or we are discussing about physical properties of group 15 elements. While explaining the physical properties of group 15 elements, I have explained you about the general electronic configuration. So what is the general electronic configuration? NS2 NP3. So the sum of valence electrons must be equal to its group number. After that, atomic radius and density about oxidation state, common oxidation state is +5, but it decreases down the group. And after that, bismuth only exhibit +3 due to inert pair effect. So that is also reason. And again after that, I have explained you about the catenation and about the nature of the bonds in of the fifth group elements. Compounds formed by nitrogen and phosphorus are covalent in nature, whereas the compounds formed by arsenic and antimony are both covalent or ionic in nature, whereas the compounds formed by bismuth are only in ionic nature. All such things are discussed in the previous class. Now we shall discuss about in this class about allotropic forms and also about how this atomicity and also anomalous behavior of nitrogen. After that we shall discuss about the chemical properties. So first, allotropic form. So what is allotropy? What is the definition for allotropy? Already we have known that the existence of an element into various forms, that is nothing but allotropy, which the exact definition you have got in fourth group elements while explaining about the allotropic forms of carbon. Carbon has three allotropic forms: diamond, graphite, fullerene, all we have discussed. So like that, the existence of an element in various forms, so that is called as allotropy. Here, among fifth group elements, except bismuth, all the group elements exhibit allotropic forms, but bismuth does not exhibit allotropic forms. That is very important. Bismuth has no allotropic forms. This is very important. Which element does not form allotropic forms? Means bismuth in the fifth group elements. Now we will see one by one what are the allotropic forms of nitrogen, phosphorus, arsenic, antimony. First, what are the allotropic forms of nitrogen? So nitrogen has two allotropic forms. One is solid form and another one is gas form. Solid nitrogen and gas nitrogen. Here the solid nitrogen has again two allotropic forms, that is alpha nitrogen and beta nitrogen. Here in the gas form it is only in the form of nitrogen only. Here again it is two types: alpha nitrogen and beta nitrogen. Alpha nitrogen and beta nitrogen. So these are the allotropic forms of nitrogen. Generally nitrogen has two allotropic forms, solid and gas. Here solid nitrogen is again two types: alpha nitrogen and beta nitrogen. After that, we are coming to phosphorus. So what are the allotropic forms of phosphorus? Phosphorus has various allotropic forms. See here. First, here white phosphorus, phosphorus and scarlet. So these are the five allotropic forms of phosphorus. Among them, these white phosphorus and red phosphorus are very important. How they form and what is the difference, which will be discussed in this class or in the next class. So now I am generally telling what are the allotropic forms. So phosphorus can exhibit five allotropic forms: violet, white phosphorus, violet phosphorus, red, black and scarlet. So these are the different types of allotropic forms exhibited by phosphorus. Whereas coming to arsenic, also exists three allotropic forms. They are, so what are the yellow, grey and black? Yellow allotropic form, grey allotropic form and black allotropic form. And also antimony. So it can also exhibit three allotropic forms. So the allotropic forms exhibited by antimony are black, yellow. Black, yellow and explosive. So these are the allotropic forms exhibited by various elements in group 15 elements. So among them, bismuth does not exist allotropic forms. Nitrogen, phosphorus, arsenic, antimony exist various allotropic forms. So now atomicity. So what is the atomicity of various elements in group 15 elements is, nitrogen is diatomic, whereas phosphorus, arsenic, antimony and bismuth all are tetraatomic. So that's why we will write nitrogen as N2, whereas phosphorus as P4, because nitrogen is diatomic, whereas phosphorus, arsenic, antimony all are tetraatomic molecules. So here, whereas coming to atomicity, nitrogen exists as diatomic. So here it can be written as N. Nitrogen exists as diatomic. Whereas arsenic, antimony, bismuth all are phosphorus, arsenic, antimony. All exist as tetraatomic. So like P4, AS4, SB4, like that. Generally, the phosphorus can be exist as like it, the phosphorus exists. Here, the bond length between phosphorus to phosphorus is 221 picometers, and here the bond angle is 60 degrees. So it is tetraatomic. All of them exist like this. And now, finally, we should have some peculiar properties of nitrogen. If they ask any question on nitrogen, you should remember that I will tell 4 points here. Basing on nitrogen, if they give any comparison question, it is diatomic, it is high stable, it is inert, it is comparison question. If they ask any comparison question with nitrogen with other element, the answer must be within the 4 points now, which I will tell you. So while if they ask any comparison question in the group 15 elements, these 4 points are enough. The answer will be in these four points only. Any point among these four points, any one point will be in that answer. So if you keep these four points in your mind, in among fifth group elements, up to 20 to 25 short answer, very short answer questions will be very easy to study you. So answer for that 20 to 25 questions in your very short answer is in these four points only, like that. If they give any comparison question, you should keep in your mind that these four points are very important. So that's why I am telling here. So nitrogen, the anomalous behavior or the variation of nitrogen with other elements is due to conditions. First one, here conditions of nitrogen. Due to small size, this is one reason. Due to high electron density, due to small size is the one reason. Due to high electron density and due to unavailability of the orbitals, due to unavailability of d orbitals, and also high bond strength, like that. Due to presence of high bond strength, due to presence of triple bond between them. So, and also it has high tendency to form p-pi bonds. It has high tendency to form p-pi bonds. So due to these reasons, nitrogen can vary with other elements very easily. If they ask any comparison question, these points must be kept in your mind. First one is due to small size, due to high electron density, due to unavailability of d orbitals, high bond strength, that is nitrogen, triple bond nitrogen, high tendency to form p-pi bonds. So this is all about physical properties. In the next class, we shall discuss about chemical properties. Thank you.